who wears a medallion on his chest. Using all his might, changing wrong to right, Prince Planet, he's the best. Now it's no surprise that he fights bad guys and he makes the bad guys pay. Whether day or night, like a flash of light, Prince Planet's on his way. Here comes Prince Planet, Prince Planet. All the things he'll do will astonish you, Prince Planet, he's the best. Race a meteor with a dinosaur, save a damsel in distress. Right before your eyes, from out of the skies, comes a hero.
Everybody, and welcome to Little Kay's Fantasy Farm.
Oh, this is so exciting, so exciting. Look, look, there's Mrs. O'Leary the cow.
That's right, Mrs. O'Leary the cow. And she's a very, very strange cow here on Fantasy Farm, because are you ready for this?
Oh, she plays the piano. Look at her go.
Look at her go. Hi, Mrs. O'Leary. Hey, let's go over and see what Hector the Chicken is doing. Let's see what Hector the Chicken's doing.
How you doing, Hector? Gee, what you doing? What you doing?
Oh, I'm just counting my eggs, counting my eggs.
No kidding. How many eggs you have there?
Oh, about six. Trying to build up our quota, you know.
No kidding.
We're working very hard back here.
It sounds like you're going to have a lot of chickens in a little bit, huh?
Oh, yes, 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 yes. Increased production, you know.
What's that? Oh, that's Babbitt the Rabbit.
Oh, Babbitt
the Rabbit, everybody. And he's trying to tell everybody something.
Oh, gee, wait.
He's trying to tell everybody it's time for Prince Planet.
Outer space, vast incalculable distances, and stars beyond the possibility of human accounting. And for each of these stars, there are a family of planets. And on many, many of these planets, there is life, intelligent life. Far from our solar system in the unknown areas hidden by galactic distance lies the planet Radion, known throughout the galaxies as the planet of universal decency. Here, civilization has reached its highest peak, not only in cold scientific advance, but in understanding. Radion, where war has been unknown for thousands of years and where each person lives in friendship with his neighbor. A planet where great stretches of the landscape have been untouched to preserve the natural wonders of mountain and valley. Radion City, capital of the planet Radion. At this very moment, representatives of all the planets in our solar system are in conference in the Great Hall. They have come to ask advice of Radion about their big problem, the Earth. Oh, and even Radion still hasn't completely licked the traffic problem.
Shame. Yes, sir, that's what you ought to be, driving your car that way with important guests from space in town, huh? Shame, huh?
Look out!
Hey, you! Don't you believe in signs? No baseball playing here.
Gee, I'm sorry, sir.
Sorry, are you? Well, it isn't enough, young man. I'm afraid we're getting too mamby-pamby with our young people.
I was wrong. That ball just flew further than I thought it would. Look, he's getting away. Look!
What? He sure is. Hey, stop! Hold in the name of the law! Oh, help! 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 Help!
Wowie! You should be more careful, officer. You could have been badly hurt. Now I'll take care of that fellow for you. Ha ha ha!
Meanwhile, the conference goes on. The chairman is the moderator of Radion, known affectionately as the chief.
Are there any more comments on this matter? The question is, shall we contact Earth and offer them membership in the Galactic Union of Worlds?
We are opposed to their membership.
I see. And your reasons?
They are warmongers and spend their time building weapons and battling each other. Besides, they foolishly believe they are the only planet in the universe with intelligent beings living on it. We don't need them.
What you say is true. Matter of fact, one of their scientists recently made the statement that there is no life on Mars. Honorable delegate from Mars, they don't even acknowledge your existence.
Earthlings are much too arrogant.
And besides, they're all such funny-looking creatures.
The Galactic Union is much too far advanced for them. They would never fit in with the rest of us.
Agreed. The very honorable delegate of Jupiter is right.
No membership!
Don't be hasty, please. Let us give the people of Earth a chance. Just because they look funny to us and behave badly doesn't mean they're all bad. Couldn't we try to help them? Give them a chance?
You know, he makes me feel just a little guilty.
I agree with Miss Venusite, and I'm pleased to say Radion's Universal Peace Corps is quite ready to accept the job.
A splendid idea, and I must suggest that only one person be sent to avoid suspicion on Earth.
Do you know of an individual who could handle such a mission, sir?
I do. Prince Planet is his name, and now we will all see him.
I'm grateful for your help in catching that fellow. By the way, you have the most remarkable powers I've ever seen, my boy.
I don't have any special powers, sir. This pendant does.
Oh, I didn't notice. I didn't. Oh, then you're a Universal Peace Corps member.
I am.
Gee, I'm sorry about my having to scold you for playing in traffic, son.
Not at all, sir. You were right and I was wrong. I apologize. I'll try to be more careful in the future. Wahoo!
Now, that young man was chosen from among many hundreds of volunteers for the special mission to Earth, the necessity for which we had foreseen for some time. Prince Planet has an IQ that is high even for our planet Radion. It is scored by Earth's standards as 300. He has been given a concentrated scientific and moral education by electro-inductive hypnotraining. By all standards of Earth, he is nothing less than a great genius. And then he has the pendant, which receives power from the nuclear energy center here on Radion. Delegates of the worlds of the Galactic Union, do you agree with our choice?
Agreed.
And so, Prince Planet is chosen to bring law and order and a love for peace to the Earth so they can become part of the Galactic Union.
Hooray!
You have been given a great task.
I shall try to live up to the honor you have bestowed upon me by choosing me out of the entire Universal Peace Corps for this job.
Prince, I'm sure you know, but...
Yes, sir.
Take special care of that pendant. We'll be sending energy to it regularly from our base on Radion, and it is essential that you be in possession of it at all times. Well, it's time.
Ready.
Good luck. Oh, wait. Don't you want to see your mother before you leave on your journey?
We've said goodbye, and she gave me her picture. I don't think I should see her again.
Brave boy.
Whether my team wins or loses, I come home with a heavy thirst. My mom knows that the best thing for me is something nourishing as well as good. And my mom never lets me down. She always keeps the refrigerator well stocked with my favorite drink, Kao. Each can is made from fresh skim milk with delicious chocolate flavor that's hard to beat. Whether she serves Kao ice cold or piping hot, it always hits the spot. Ask mom to stock up on my favorite drink, Kao. One taste, and I'm sure it'll be your favorite drink, too. Don't forget, when you go to the grocery store, stop in front of the Kale display. Make sure you have enough for yourself and your friends who come to your house. K KO. It won't make you a winner every time, but it'll sure make losing a lot easier to take. Drink KO and see how much fun it can be.
From the opening instructions to the final buzzer, it's basketball action at its best, as our Chicago Bulls climb to the top of the National Basketball Association. Channel 44 brings all the excitement and action of every Chicago Bull road game into your living room in glorious color, live and direct from basketball capitals across the country. If you like basketball, you'll love Channel 44, Chicago's television sports center, the home of exciting Chicago Bulls.
Oh, it hurts. Oh, let go. Oh, my gosh. Oh, let go. Oh, my thumb. Oh, it hurts.
What's going on here? Little K, where are you? Little K?
I'm over here.
Where? Sounds like he's coming back. Are you in there?
Yeah, I'm in here, and it hurts. Oh, gee.
Excuse me, everybody. I'll be right back. I've got to see if I could find him. Little K, what's going on here?
Oh, it hurts. Oh, gee whiz. He did it. He's the guilty one. He did it.
Would you please calm down now? Just calm down. Now, what?
He did.
Would you please calm down? Now, what exactly are you trying to say?
Hector the Chicken did it. He did it. He got my thumb.
You're trying to... Oh, don't... Okay, I won't touch you. Are you saying that Hector the Chicken bit your thumb?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I don't believe... Excuse me. I'm gonna settle this thing once and for all. Hector! Heck!
Woo! He did it. He's the guilty one.
Oh, come on.
It's
now.
Not Heck... true!
Wait a minute. I'm gonna get this straight. Hector, little K here says that you bit his thumb.
It's a lie!
Wait a minute. Would you let her finish? Go ahead, Hector.
It's a lie. You tell the truth now, little K. You know what happened. You were playing in back of the chicken coop, and you got your finger caught in the door.
Uh-oh. Now I know the story.
It's a terrible thing
to
lie.
I think I know what happened. Little K, were you playing back there?
Admit it!
Wait a minute. Is there a slight possibility, maybe? Just a slight possibility that maybe... Is there a slight possibility that maybe you did get your finger caught in the door?
Well, it was kind of dark there.
I thought. I'll tell you
truth.
What. Let me take a look at it.
No, don't.
Okay, I'm not gonna hurt you. I just want to take a look at your thumb.
No, don't touch it. Let me see. Oh, look at that.
Hey, I have a way of cheering you up.
You do?
Yeah, I do. Remember the song Thumbelina?
Sure.
Now, I bet if you and I sing the song, we can do it together, and I bet your thumb will be much better. You think so? Okay, you ready?
Okay, here we go.
Though you're no bigger than my thumb.
Than your thumb.
Oh, than my thumb.
Oh, your thumb.
Then my thumb.
Sweet Thumbelina, don't be glum.
And you'll grow.
Oh, Thumbelina, tiny little thing. Thumbelina, dance.
Good.
Thumbelina, sing.
Oh, Thumbelina, what's the difference if you're very small?
When your heart is full of love,
you're 9 feet tall, and you're no bigger than my toe.
Than your toe.
Oh, than my toe.
Oh, your toe.
Than my toe. Sweet Thumbelina, she will grow.
And she'll grow.
Thumbelina, tiny little thing.
Thumbelina, dance.
Oh, Thumbelina, sing. Oh, Thumbelina, what's the difference if you're very small?
When your heart is full of love, you're 9 feet tall.
Wow, that was terrific. How about getting back to our short story, the conclusion of Prince Planet. Take it away.
All right, begin countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, fire!
And thus the fantastic adventures of Prince Planet begin. Assigned one of the most difficult jobs ever attempted, he is on his way to Earth. His assignment? To fight evil and cruelty whenever and wherever it affects the planet Earth. The distance from Radion to Earth is measured not in miles, but in light years. And even at the fantastic speed of the nuclear rocket, it is a long, wearying distance. The prince is under the influence of an electrohypnotic device so that he will sleep through the entire trip. All controls are under automatic computer programming. And if all goes well, Prince Planet should arrive on Earth refreshed and ready for immediate action, if needed. But all does not go well. Radioactivity drifting in space affects the automatic controls, and alarm buzzers begin to sound. And Prince Planet is rudely awakened.
What? Oh, have I landed?
Operations base on Radion calling Prince Planet. Prince Planet, please come in. Oh, he's unconscious. Prince! Prince Planet, this is the chief. Wake up! Wake up, please! This is the... The screen! It's gone dark!
Overload, I'm afraid. It broke radio contact with him. I sure hope he gets there without trouble.
Prince, answer me. It's the chief. Prince, please answer.
Don't worry about me, sir.
If this trip is getting to be too dangerous, you have permission to return.
Oh, no, sir. I'm fine. I can handle it all right.
You will soon be landing. Do you have any special requests?
Maybe there is one thing that you can do for me that will help me in my work on Earth. I believe it can be done.
And what is that?
Give me the ability, through the pendant, to change my appearance to that of a normal Earth boy and to change back to Prince Planet when I must. It sure would help. You see, I'm going to stay on Earth a long while, sir, and when I'm off duty, I'd like the chance to live as a normal boy.
Very well. Better prepare yourself for treatment transmission.
Thank you, sir. I'll get ready right now.
He's ready. Start the adaptation treatment.
This would be if each afternoon at 3 every kid could have a can of KO
after school.
Icy cold or steaming hot, what a flavor KO's got. If it's chocolatey as it can be, it's KO.
KO, KO.
If you want to spell delicious, here's the only way to go. Spell it
K-A-Y
and O-O-O-O-O. When you've got KO on your mind, you'll accept no other kind of chocolate drink. You'll have to think about it.
There's a sports extravaganza all week long on your station for sports, Channel 44. On Monday, the ring explodes with left hooks and right jabs on Boxing from the Forum. Tuesdays bring the brains and brawn of Bob Luce Wrestling to your screen. On Wednesday, see the champions and the challengers on Boxing from Olympic. On Thursday, you'll see everything from splits to strikes on Championship Bowling. Friday night brings you Chicago Wrestling with Bob Luce and a ring full of excitement. On Sunday, get hunting and fishing tips from the Outdoor Sportsman. All this, plus the Chicago Bulls and Indiana and Purdue basketball, round out your sports viewing. That's on Chicago's Television Sports Center, Channel 44.
Well, the old clock in the wall says it's time to say goodbye. And remember, everybody, oh, if we can make just one friend every day.
Oh, like you out there. Oh, we just want to say
thank you all for coming here today.
We'll see you all tomorrow for another pleasant day.
Bye, everybody.
It's a world of laughter, a world of tears. It's a world of
night when Prince Planet's rocket lands on Earth, not far from mountain country, in the big ranch area of the far west. Morning comes and the song of a bird can be heard mingling with the sound of splashing waters. But there is no sound from the spaceship. A short distance down the stream, a girl is watering her horse.
You should have had your fill by now. Let's get going.
She rides off across the fields, little suspecting that she is riding toward adventure, such as she has never known before.
I smell smoke, I think. I see you smell it too, Pony. Let's investigate.
From another planet, a place called Radion.
My boy, don't bother with so many explanations tonight. You'll have plenty of time for that because I'm asking you to stay with us right here at the Worthy Ranch.
Meanwhile, out in the oil field...
Ready to begin the boring, boss.
Great. If I can't buy the land to get the oil, I'll just steal it this way. I'll show that guy Worthy that he can't stand in the way of Sylvester Sleech. Okay, ready?
There goes that drill. We'll soon see, boss.
Yeah. Wahoo! Here it comes, boys. Oil. Look at it.
Diana, wait, please.
But I must help my father.
Look, that fire has crude oil as its fuel. It can't be put out by ordinary methods.
But we have to do something. We can't just leave father out there all alone.
Diana, just leave this to me.
Molecular
our conversion was dependent. You've got to get the mathematics exactly right to make a rocket extinguisher out of that little one.
Destroy the ranch if we don't do something quick.
Don't worry. I know just what to do.
Oh. What do we do?
Get down on the ground.
Yes, sir.
Money. Wait! Hey! Hey!
So much for Sleech. Diana, I'm called Prince Planet, and I've been sent to Earth to fight evil and injustice.
Prince Planet.
Diana, can you think of an ordinary name, one that I can use while I'm living here on Earth? You know, just an everyday boy's name, one that you might like.
Well, let me see. Bobby would be nice.
Then Bobby it will be. You know, I think I'm going to like helping the people of Earth and living here.
And so Prince Planet has made a place for himself on Earth and found two wonderful new friends in the bargain, Diana Worthy and her father, Pop. And what's more, he has a new name for his everyday life, Bobby. A fine start for the exciting career that is to come.
A group of scientists and writers make a successful landing on the red planet Mars. To their surprise, the planet is inhabited by a superior...